Everyone could please stand. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, we give Almighty God Allah praise and thanks. We thank Almighty God Allah for all the Abrahamic prophets who came in a mighty line of divine. Today, let us thank Almighty God Allah for Abraham. Let us thank him for Moses. Let us thank him for Jesus, and we thank him for Muhammad. May the peace and blessings of Almighty God Allah be upon these great and worthy servants of his. Oh, but I would be remiss in my duty if I did not thank Almighty God Allah enough for intervening in our affairs in the person of Master Farid Muhammad, the great Mahdi, who came among us seeking to save a people totally destroyed, a man who came from the East, and he found us after we had been totally destroyed. We lost our God. We lost our name. We lost our religion, our culture. We was turned upside down and inside out, and an oppressor beat us into the ground. But we thank this great one who was expected to come, and he came. And he raised from among us that Georgia-born black man by the name of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. He is the exalted Christ. We thank him, for he became for us the first begotten of the dead. And in his absence, we are eternally grateful from that eternal leader of the nation of Islam. That man, the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, gave birth to a son to where we could say, for unto us a child was born. For unto us a son was given, that magnificent leader who is responsible for saving the lives of so many. That man is the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. It is in their names that we greet all of you who are here to celebrate the life of a brother who is a soldier's soldier. Can't get it twisted when it comes to Brother Shaheed. That's a visit that, if you got that visit, he came to straighten matters out. Huh? So let's give a hand for a soldier like this. Let's show some love for our dear brother, Captain Emeritus Shaheed Muhammad. Takbir! Takbir! Brothers and sisters, just to familiarize you with our way, the way that we lost. Our open enemies took everything from us. It took our religion, our culture, our way, and you will witness us celebrating in the way of our ancestors. You don't hear any sad music, and you won't hear that today. For we're taught that the death or the passing of one we love is already sad enough. The flowers that you see, they are beautiful. But Brother Shaheed cannot smell the flowers. We should make an attempt to give flowers while we live. Each and every one of you know something of Brother Shaheed, or you wouldn't be here. As I look in this room and see all the lives that he touched, this is a shining example that his life was not in vain. And I thank Allah for Brother Captain Shaheed, because if you, I don't know if I should use the word, but you know, you kind of rub people the wrong way. But let me just say, if you had any punk in you, a weakness in you, when you met this man and you got trained by this man, all of that ran down the street. What an honor to celebrate our brother. And so we will start our program off with the reading of the obituary. And that reading will be done by a longtime companion of Brother Captain Shaheed, Brother Abdullah Muhammad.
Assalamu alaikum. Thank you, Brother Student Minister Abdul Malik Sayyid Muhammad, the Western Region Representative for the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, to the Supreme Captain, the Student Supreme Captain, Brother Mustafa Farrakhan, Brother Student Minister, Student Captain Emeritus, Brother Emeritus, Brother Shaheed, I'm honored to stand before you to give a brief scenario of the Student Captain Emeritus Abdul Shaheed Ali Muhammad. At the top of your page of the obituary, you see the Arabic inscription. It says Allah. Look a little bit closer, you see the shadow of the Arabic inscription, Allah. The man amongst men, Big Cat, Shaheed Muhammad, was born September 23rd, 1947 to Elise and Miles Holmes Sr. in Cook County Hospital in Chicago, Illinois. Shaheed's parents were religious people. That, like many Southern black people, migrated from Mississippi. Shaheed was the youngest of four children. The passing of their father when Shaheed was two years old, along with the age gap between himself and his siblings, shaped him in a very independent and ambitious, child. At the age of four years old, he walked several blocks by himself to the public swimming pool, the Independence. And by the age of seven, he already knew how to make French fries from a pound of potatoes. Shaheed's business acumen registered early when his other brother Miles gave him his newspaper route. And Miles demanded all the money. Shaheed knew to take his off the top. Shortly before Shaheed's mother Shaheen's mother moved her family from Chicago to Los Angeles in 1955. His desire to change the condition of black people was ignited by seeing the body of Emmett Till and witnessing his 15-year-old cousin being shot down simply because he was black. Upon arriving in Los Angeles, Shaheen recognized right away that things moved much faster and people were much more disorderly in the quote-unquote Wild Wild West. The police terrorized the neighborhoods and the people were just as aggressive. Shaheen's older brother taught him how to box. That's plural. Shaheen's older brothers, Miles and JJ, taught him how to box. And the boys in schools were always fighting. So when the boys in schools came to fight Shaheen, he always fought back. He had no fear. He took delight in taking on any bully. And eventually he became a bully to the bullies. Shaheen attended 99th Street Elementary, George Washington Carver Junior High, Thomas Jefferson High School, and ultimately graduated from George Washington High School in 1965. He was accepted. Shaheen was accepted. Student Captain Emeritus Abdul Shaheed Ali Muhammad was accepted to Winston-Salem State College, where he played with NBA legend Earl the Pearl Monroe, also nicknamed Black Jesus. Shaheen was very proud that his basketball team won the NCAA College Division title. It was the first time a team from a historical black college or university, historically black college or university, HBCU, to win an NCAA championship in any sport. Shaheen went on to try out and briefly play in the NBA with the Portland Trail Blazers. He never stopped playing basketball. Shaheen played basketball in both Compton and Carson at Gonzales Park, Rogers Park in Inglewood, Mas Maryam Gym. I've been told to stick with the script. But I gotta tell you one story about Mas Maryam Gym. We was playing basketball in Mas Maryam Gym around 1982. And we was playing another team, and we played about three games. They beat us every game. We played another game, they beat us that game. Shaheen said, one more game. He wouldn't quit until we won. He wasn't gonna let nobody come open Mas Maryam and beat us without a win. Then you could go home after you got beat. That's a variation from the script. Back to the script. He also played at Wilson Park in Compton, Green Meadows Park in Los Angeles. But it wasn't just about playing basketball. When Shaheen would play, run up and down the court for 3-4 hours, he would take the young men, arrange chairs as we're sitting in today, and teach them about the coming of the Savior, Master Farhad Muhammad, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, the Honorable Mr. Louis Farrakhan. So he used those efforts of his as a training and a recruiting of men. Some referred, Shaheen's basketball was his obsession. Some referred to him as a shooting coach because of his meticulous shooting technique. He coached several players to the league, the NBA, National Basketball Association. Off of the basketball court, into the mean streets of Los Angeles, Shaheen developed a reputation for having hardcore business mannerisms with no nonsense. Shaheen's influence grew and he gained prestige in the streets. Shaheen's giant physique and his brute persona horrified those that stood in opposition to him. He joined the Black Panther Party for self-defense in the mid to late 60s. And he used those qualities to become an enforcer for the Black Panther Party for Self-Defense. He became appointed as Sergeant at Arms because of his marksmanship and unfettered courage. Astaghfirullah. His aforementioned childhood experiences shaped him into a natural defender. Thank you, sir. His aforementioned childhood experiences shaped him into a natural defender for Black empowerment. During his time in the Black Panther Party for Self-Defense, he developed a tight friendship with a Panther who came to be known as Dr. Khalil Abdul Muhammad. In 1969, Shaheed became a registered member in the Nation of Islam, the NOI, which changed the trajectory of his life and his purpose forever. This decision forms the foundation for the legacy that he leaves. Shaheed was an elite fruit of Islam, FOI. He sold 1,000 Muhammad Speaks newspapers each week and would fill his Rolls Royce. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us to have the best. Beyond capacity to bring guests, he worked his way up to become a captain under the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, assigned by Imam Ali Rashid, formerly known as Captain Edward Sorrell, Captain Edward Rashid. In 1982, he joined on with Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan's efforts to rebuild the Nation of Islam and became a substantial part of the process on the West Coast by forming study groups. This led to the reopening of Muhammad Mosque 54 in Compton, where he became the captain. Due to Compton being a primary target of the CIA, Contra, crack cocaine epidemic, Muhammad Mosque 54 was one of his proudest accomplishments. Student Captain Emeritus Abdul Shaheed Ali Muhammad, under the guidance of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, became an integral part of lives being saved, streets being cleaned, the community being protected, the gang truces implemented, employment being created, and the mayor, Brother Omar Bradley's in the house, being elected in Compton. Shaheed became instrumental in attracting several local entertainers to Muhammad Mosque number 54, including MC Ren, Big Ice Cube, and West Coast Cam, known to the believers as Lieutenant Craig. Shaheed affirmed that he witnessed a miracle on October 16, 1995, at the Million Man March. He established the first regional office to promote the Million Man March in Compton and gave sponsorships to several Black men to attend the Million Man March. Compton City Council proceeded to award Shaheed's efforts by giving the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan the key to the city of Compton, declaring the Million Man March as a local holiday, and declaring February 26 as Master Father Muhammad Day. To my knowledge, I don't know of any other city in the United States that ever declared a Master Father Muhammad Day. Yours truly was in a position that particular day to receive that proclamation. Student Captain Emeritus Abdul Shaheed Ali Muhammad was blessed to be one of the pioneers of the original E-Team, the security for the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, securing the minister on all four occasions on the National Mall, and touring the world with Minister Farrakhan on three separate occasions. An exemplary entrepreneur and businessman, Shaheed built wealth, community, and family. Shaheed had many successes in this world. The California State Athletic Commission licensed Student Captain Emeritus Abdul Shaheed Ali Muhammad to manage professional boxers, including world heavyweight contender Lionel Butler. Shaheed's security company headed the security for heavyweight champions Lennox Lewis and Mike Tyson. His entrepreneurial achievements include a car dealership, a jewelry store, a fish restaurant, a music distribution company, a real estate investor, and a very successful mediation, if you understand what I mean, and collection company. Shahid was also an invaluable business consultant. The fruit of Islam are taught to be brothers, saints, scholars, and soldiers. It says killers there, soldiers. Brother Shahid definitely checked some of those boxes. Shahid was born for the struggle. He hated the condition that black people lived under. He always wanted to see it change. When you heard the Honorable Elijah Muhammad say he met with God face to face, he investigated it. The messenger teaches us, check it out. With his knowledge of the Bible, spawned from his mother's religious faith, he instantly believed it. He lived it. He knew it. Allahu Akbar. A man of stature, faith, family, most of all, brotherhood. Student Captain Emeritus Abdul Shahid Ali Muhammad leaves to carry on his legacy. A staunch soldier, his wife of 17 years, Sister Tiffany Muhammad. His children, Kelly, Kareem, Daoud, Kiyama, Kenyatti, Malik, Aisha, Amir, Sharif, Diana, Ziyada, and Ibn Shahid. 27, what's that number? 27. I've been told to stick with the script. But we all know the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan was the minister at Mosque number 27. And now he's at the headquarters at number 2, and we on the West Coast at 27. I say it over and over again. There's no mistake. And 5, how many pillars of Islam? 5 great-grandchildren, dearly beloved Muslim believers. His siblings, Juanita Holmes, Noria, Miles Holmes Jr., and James Holmes, preceded him in death. Beautiful brothers and sisters. They loved his brother, Shahid. He loved them. And he leaves his brother, Reuben Peer. The Flynn in the house? SubhanAllah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Host of nieces, nephews, family, friends, and mentees. His was a life well lived. He was a man and well loved. A father, a husband, a leader, a legacy of honor and integrity. My brother, my friend, student captain, Emeritus Abdul Shahid Ali Muhammad. Rest well, brother. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Thank you for your time.
When you hear the term Allahu Akbar, it only means God is the greatest. Again, dear family, on behalf of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, his beautiful wife, Sister Khadija Farrakhan, and the Farrakhan family, on behalf of the National Council of Laborers in this grateful nation of Islam, and to our supreme captain, Brother Mustafa Farrakhan, who's with us today, we are honored to be in your presence, Brother Captain. Yes, sir. And all the captains, many from around the nation is here to honor this soldier today. Oh, come on, y'all could do better than that. What an honor. Also, many of the ministers from around the Western region and throughout the country, they're here as well. Honored to have you all with us today, standing with this family and our friend, Brother Shahid Muhammad. Shahid means, in one sense, a witness, and he definitely was a witness because he believed deeply in the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. We believe we received the revelation directly from God. And when Shahid heard that, he stood up to be a witness for his teacher, for his nation, for his people. Also, Shahid means, in one sense, a martyr. A martyr. A martyr is a person who suffers or dies deliberately for the sake of affirming what he or she believes. Good God Almighty. He dies deliberately. This is what we love about the Nation of Islam and our teacher, that when we take on this mission of helping us suffering people, we are ready to put our life in harm's way. So we're all honored to have met Brother Shahid Muhammad. It is our prayers, dear family, that Allah lifts the burden of grief from this family as this celebration of Brother Shahid's life, we want you to know that the Nation of Islam, we are live streaming this celebration to the entire world. The world that this man traveled with the Messiah, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. Wherever you've seen the minister, whether it was in Africa, whether it was in the Middle East, whether it was in Central and South America, not too far behind him, you will see this giant ready to handle the business. So the whole world is able to tune in to Los Angeles to celebrate the life of Brother Shahid Muhammad. So may Allah to the family lift the burden of grief from your hearts. May he ease your sorrow. And may Allah bless you to know that this brother, as the Holy Quran says to us, those who die or is slain in the way of God, never consider them as dead. A man like this can't die. If you was trained by Brother Shahid, his spirit, the energy that was in that body can neither be created nor destroyed. But guess what? It does change its forms. So for those of us who was trained by Brother Captain Shahid, let us ask Allah, give us a double portion of his spirit that we now will carry on the work that he helped to establish in Compton, California, and all over the world. We will soldier from now on in his spirit. Now that's serious. In his spirit. He was at a moment's notice ready to give his life for this teaching and this nation. And if you know Brother Shahid, you wanted to show him love. I remember 2 weeks ago, a brother said, I love you, Brother Shahid. He said, yeah, right. How many papers you selling? How many guests you getting, brother? Huh? He was that kind of man. It wasn't about him. It was about the mission And all of us, if you are not living your life in service to your people, you don't know what you're missing. So we thank Allah for Brother Shaheed. For I would love to, at this time, as I spoke to our leader and teacher, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, he sends his greetings to the family, to all of those who was touched by Brother Captain Shaheed. He sends his greetings of Assalamu Alaikum. I shall, and in that spirit, he said, brother, tell the people that anytime there was trouble in me rebuilding the teachings of my father, there was Shaheed. He said, brother, that brother is a soldier's soldier. Then, as I was speaking to our Native American family who's with us today, because we're one people, the black and the red and the brown, we are one people. And as I was speaking to my Native family, they were saying, Brother Shaheed was a warrior. And the minister this morning said to me, brother, he was a warrior's warrior. And he will be truly missed in the physical, but we will carry him on in our spirit. And I, as his student minister, I'm asking not just the FOI in the Los Angeles area, but all over this globe. Let us beg Allah for a double portion of his spirit, because black and oppressed people is in trouble, and we have to build this army to ward off the plans of Satan to destroy us all. Brothers and sisters, the Holy Quran says to us that every soul must taste death. The only way to avoid death is to have never lived. We are taught from the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad that funerals are not for the dead or the departed. Funerals are for the living. And when we come to the service of a servant like this, each of us have to get a chance to reflect. What kind of life are you living? See? Jacob, when he was dying on his bed, he called his family around him. He didn't even want to know how much they loved him. He said these words, "What will you worship after me?" And the children replied that we will worship the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac. We will worship the one God only. And when Jacob heard that, as I see his sons and his daughters and his children, you could see their father's spirit and faith all up in them. This is why he will never die. The love that I watch the family that you have for this warrior, it is so deep that it is now imprinted in your DNA. And the love that you have for your father now through your seed. See, you will pass him on. God is not a destroyer of life. He's a recycler of life. And I promise you, if you have not seen it already, family, but real soon, either a little boy child or a girl child, you will see his character come right up out of them, and you will say, there he go. Little Shaheed is back. He never died. God, give us the best of this, your servant, and forgive him his sins and allow him to enter into paradise. Brothers and sisters, This man that we are here to celebrate today, the Holy Quran says this in Surah 89 called The Daybreak. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. O soul that art at rest, return to thy Lord well pleased, well pleasing, and enter in among my servants. I believe that our brother, his soul, his spirit is with the Creator. And Allah says in the Holy Quran, when a misfortune comes into the life of a believer only says, from Allah I came, and to Allah I must return. All of us are only here for a fleeting moment. We're only here for the little dash between our birth and the time the sun set on our life. The question is, in that dash, what did you do? In that dash, did you put your life in service to others? Did you leave out the selfish world? Brother Shaheed gave up an incredible lifestyle. Y'all did hear about his lifestyle. He gave it up for the suffering of his people when he saw the murder of Emmett Till. And he heard the call from God to be a vanguard. And I thank Brother Shaheed for when I joined the nation in 1985, my eighth month, I believe, in the nation, I came to California because California was known as West Point. And I was from a little country boy from Georgia. About yourself. But I was coming to the West Coast, where the strongest of black people migrated, that in Alabama, when the slave master could not break us, we would migrate into Texas. And when our Texas slave master couldn't break us, our people kept migrating to the West. And so the West Coast ended up with some of the most rebellious of our people against the oppressor. And so when I came to Los Angeles in 1985 and I met this tall brother, and I must have not looked right, he said, brother, stand straight. I was leaning on the wall. He said, brother, Muslims don't lean on walls. So I stood at attention and he said, you're that brother from Atlanta. I said, yes, sir. He said, well, brother, don't be like Gladys Knight, because L.A. can be too much for the man. And he knew I could fish and bring people, and he taught me techniques. But more importantly, he taught me about the soldiers under the Honorable Elijah Muhammad so that I could get into their spirit. And he taught me how to fish a brother in a modern day context. And he said to me, brother, whatever you do, don't you stop looking at Minister Farrakhan. You watch him and you won't sink, brother. And then he said, get off that sugar. And he said, practice how to eat to live. I thank Allah for this great warrior, brother Shaheed Muhammad. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan said, our nation of Islam, we are so grateful that Allah loaned him to us. And that Shaheed practiced his religion. Now he's returned back to the God, and the God will determine well pleased. And he left us here to do the work. So I say to the family, let us pledge our life to live it commensurate in the way that Brother Shaheed lived his. Do something for your poor people. Do something for your suffering people. And show your love and respect for the nation of Islam that he gave his life to. And so we are eternally grateful that Brother Shaheed Muhammad came our way. And so at this time, as you see the casket, Brother Shaheed's body is in that casket and his head is facing the east and his feet is facing the west. We're taught that the sun rises in the east, so turn his head east. And his feet is facing the west because the sun sets in the west. But something is going to happen real soon. If it please Allah, with what Brother Shaheed has left us with, the best of him, I believe in the last day you'll see the sun rising in the west. We are taught from the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad that when a traveler travels, he travels from east to west. And so, Brother Shaheed physically is no longer among us, but to this beautiful family, call him up anytime. He's on speed dial. You don't need an iPhone to call up Brother Shaheed now. Just close your eyes when you miss him. Call him up. And he will appear right there. You already know what he's going to say. If you have a question, you already know the answer. You know the look that he's going to give you. Huh? And now we will have the brothers to turn the casket to where the head will be facing north and the feet will be facing south. And so with his casket, we will make a cross. Jesus said these words, must I bear my cross alone? No. There's a cross for me, and there is a cross for you. So as they turn the casket and his head is facing the polar caps to the north, called the North Pole, and the polar cap to the south, called the South Poles, this represent that our beautiful brother will no longer walk among us. He's frozen in this state, but his spirit is alive. His spirit is in us. And so at this time, we will come down to do the janazah. We will ask his sons to join us with the Supreme Captain, and we will perform the janazah prayer. We also will ask that every male member in this audience would come and form a line, even if it takes us all the way up on the stage, in honor of Brother Student Captain Emeritus Shaheed Muhammad. Sons. Come over here. Let this. Okay, son. You good? Yes, just a little bit more. Sisters, we're going to calm your way. Come on, brothers. Move fast. You know, Shaheed didn't move that slow. Get in tight, brothers. Shoulder to shoulder. Straighten the lines. We need straight lines. Don't get it straight. Y'all know Brother Shaheed was very tidy. He didn't like messy. Come on, brothers. This is an honor. Brothers, continue to come behind. Get up on the stage. Straight line, shoulder to shoulder. Don't be afraid to lock in with your brothers. This is how we came over here. Different tribes in the hull of those ships. Enemies in the hull of those ships, but our oppressor did not realize we united under strange circumstances, under oppression. And so today we unite for this great soldier, Brother Captain Shaheed. Continue to come, brothers, and make your way to the back. Wow, look at this. Look at the men that this man touched. Wow. Takbir!
Allahu Akbar!
Takbir!
Allahu Akbar!
Long live the spirit of Brother Captain Shaheed Muhammad. Brothers, continue to move. All right, we will start the janazah. Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Oh Allah, blessed is your name and exalted is your majesty. There is none worthy of worship except thee. In the name of Allah, the beneficent, the merciful, all praise is due to Allah, the Lord of the world. The beneficent, the merciful, master of this day of requital. Thee do we serve and thee do we seek for help. Guide us on the right path, the path of those upon whom thou hast bestowed favors, not the path of those upon whom your wrath is brought down, nor of those who go astray. Allahu Akbar.
Allah,
oh Allah, make Muhammad successful and make the true and righteous followers of Muhammad successful as thou didst make Abraham and the true and righteous followers of Abraham successful. For surely thou art praised and magnified in thy midst forever. And oh Allah, bless Muhammad and bless the true and righteous followers of Muhammad as thou didst bless Abraham and the true and righteous followers of Abraham, for surely thou art praised and magnified in thy midst forever. Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
O Allah, grant protection to our living and grant protection to our dead and grant protection to our old and to our young, and to our males, and to our females. Allahu Akbar.
Allahu
Akbar. O Allah, whomsoever thou grantest to live, make them to live in submission to you. And O Allah, whomsoever thou cause to die, make them to die in faith. And O Allah, please do not deny us of his reward. And please do not make us enter into trial after him. O Allah, thank you for this, your servant, Brother Shaheed Muhammad, and bless us to live a life commensurate to the life and teachings that he gave his life to. We thank you, O Allah, as we all say together in unity and in strength, we say, I mean. Takbir!
Allahu Akbar!
Takbir!
Allahu Akbar!
Takbir!
Allahu Akbar!
Takbir!
Allahu Akbar!
Thank you, brothers. You may take your seats. Thank you, brother. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, brother. Man. Thank you, brother. Wow. Thank you. Man, thank y'all for sharing your father, brother. Thank you. Thank you, brother. Man. Thank you, brother. Beautiful. That's right, brothers. Brother Shaheed, come on, everybody stay with us. Return back to your seats. Man, our supreme captain said, this is black manhood. Come on, y'all, give another round of applause. Show your love as we celebrate the life of Brother Captain Shaheed Muhammad. Bear with us, brothers, if we would take our seats. At this time, brothers and sisters, we're taught from the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad that in our services, we're going to pass out to each and every person that's here, if the sisters would come forward, and each person will get a mint candy. And what we would like for you to do once you get that mint is to take it out of the wrap and put that mint into your mouth. It really helps in the grieving process. It also helps something else, but we won't go there. Just a little halitosis, you know. You know, this is beautiful to laugh in celebration of a life of a man like this. To the family, you're going to have moments. It's going to come and go. Boy, but with time, you'll be all right. And if we, your family, the nation of Islam, if we could do anything to serve you, we are duty bound to do that for you as your husband, your brother, your uncle, your granddad served so many. Did you see the men who stood behind this brother's casket? Oh, the world is in trouble today because we intend to finish the work. But as you put the mint into your mouth, it represents life and the fullness of that life. And so as your saliva began to erode away at the candy, so is life. Life have a way of eroding the body away because the body that Brother Shaheed lived in couldn't carry his spirit anymore. His spirit was so powerful that the body could not hold it. So as the candy began to fade in your mouth, the only thing that will be left is the sweetness of the candy or the sweetness of the memory. Let us all take Brother Shaheed and internalize him in our memory and never forget a man like this. He is a martyr in the nation of Islam, and his name will be remembered at Muhammad's Mosque number 27 forever. That when Allah bless us to open up our new mosque and school, our children and our children's children will learn about the history of this great captain. I promise you, we will never forget him. We will find a place for his picture to be placed in the proper place. So with that, brothers and sisters, as if all of us have received our candy, we will take our brother's body to its final resting place. And those of us who Brother Shaheed served, let us put him away all the way. You will see us carry his body on our shoulder. We never carry the casket below our waist. No, we carry it on our shoulders, because he is to us what any general is to America. In fact, he's greater than any general that ever lived in this United States government, because this man worked to help establish the kingdom of God on earth. Our general. No disrespect to Colin Powell or any other generals, but this one, a little different. So with that, brothers and sisters, those of you, we're going to ask you, you can come and walk by. We're not going to have parting views. Yes. But we just wanted to have just an original salute to our dear brother and captain. And this original salute will be done by the Assistant Supreme Captain of the Nation of Islam, Brother Aziz.
Thank you, Brother Minister. Family, what we're going to do is we're going to salute this soldier's soldier. We're going to salute this warrior's warrior. But we want everyone who would like to be, who sees themselves as a soldier, to stand. The way we're going to do this is the way this brother moved. We're going to salute. We're going to give. I'm going to call out original salute, and we will bring the hand up, right hand. We're going to bring it up to our brow. So it's going to be done quickly, but then as the minister was talking about, we're going to lower it so that it lasts all the way until we put it down. And now we'll say ready front, and we'll do that. So everyone together, original salute. Ready front. Our soldier, our brother, our friend. Thank you.
Takbir. 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 Long live the spirit of Brother Captain Shaheed Muhammad. With that being said, brothers and sisters, if you would really just, you know, come by and depart from the doors, we'll line up and the family will have just a little moment with Brother Shaheed. So if you would just come by, won't be any parting views. You could go to your cars. And don't forget, the repast is at 3 o'clock at Compton College. Look, if you have anything that you want to give, I know the city wants to give proclamation, bring them to the repast. If you have anything you want to say to the family on how Shaheed beat you, talk to you or train you. You know, right. Bring it to the repast, you know. If he owe you any money, just go ahead and forget that, all right? But please, we're going to all come to the repast and share words with the family. Thank you, brothers and sisters. Thank you.